As of December 21st of 2025, there are currently 41 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 4 less than were erupting last week. While it might be a tad controversial to place this volcano here, one of these erupting volcanoes is Mount Mayon in the Philippines. Sometime around December 8th, fresh dark-colored lava very weakly pushed its way through Mayon's summit dome. This has led to small parts of its lava dome breaking off and falling down slope, creating 53 rockfalls during the last week, of which this video shows one of them. Now, there is the potential that Mayon is still not technically erupting, but rather what we are seeing could be the result of cooling 2023 lava being pushed upwards due to increased pressure in its magma conduit. Regardless of which is the case, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, volcanic ash was detected in the vicinity of the populated Kodiak Island, and yet, this was not due to a new volcanic eruption. Meanwhile, in the section of Papua New Guinea that should, theoretically speaking, become a new country in 2027, the Bagana volcano produced a new, highly viscous lava flow. And in what is this week's top story, the volcano in Tonga that formed one of the world's newest islands in 2022 erupted again, with there now even being a potential chance that an explosive eruption could happen. What I'm referring to is the uninhabited home Reef volcano 242 kilometers north of Tonga's capital, which has remained as an above sea level volcanic island ever since it erupted in 2022. Ever since then, it has continued to grow, erupting once in 2023, twice in 2024, and now twice in 2025. Home Reef's latest eruption began on December 17th when satellite imagery picked up both a distinctive eruption plume and multiple heat signatures. Subsequent days continued to pick up the same signatures, and further analysis showed something interesting. As it appears as though the new lava which has erupted is a bit darker than the rest of the island, which is composed of first dacite and then andesite. While unproven, I am suspicious that the actively erupting lava is far more mafic, with a basaltic andesite composition much like what Paracutin erupted from 1943 to 1952. Regardless of composition, there is a potential concern. This lava seems to be building up above the explosion crater and thus magma conduit that formed during a previous eruption. As a result, it could eventually become thick enough that it forms a plug, causing pressure to build, and this could lead to an explosive eruption. Or, this lava lobe could be less harmful and flow beyond the crater rim and create a lobe that enters the ocean and creates new land. It will be interesting to see what happens next, but in my opinion, I recommend staying at least 4 kilometers away from the eruption for now. Meanwhile, in Alaska, two volcanic ash plumes rose from Katmai National Park, which were visible from satellite, but a new or ongoing volcanic eruption was not to blame. Instead, sometimes any area that recently experienced a major explosive eruption that ejected large quantities of tephra can have said tephra become remobilized by strong winds for years, decades, and sometimes more than a century after that eruption happened. This is exactly what happened on both December 10th and December 12th as strong up to 40 mph winds remobilized some of the loose tephra deposits from Novarupta's 1912 eruption. And, on the island of Bougainville in Papua New Guinea, the Bagana volcano produced a new branch of a lava flow that for multiple months has emanated from its summit vent. This has advanced on its north flank to the northwest during the last 2 weeks, advancing a full 650 meters. Yes, this is a slow speed, but is not too surprising considering the unusual type of volcano Bagana is, a lava cone. While typical andesite stratovolcanoes are composed of overlapping layers of lava and ash, Bagana is just one high-output volcano with overlapping loads of viscous lava. While it still has produced some ash and pyroclastic flows in the past, these represent a minority of its edifice. The latest lava flow is merely continuing the process of growing this lava cone, which has been nearly continuously erupting for more than a century. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 20th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member CocoFay666 for supporting my work.